to the water tube boiler, right? So five tube boilers, first boiler is the four-cone boiler. You can see this simple type vertical boiler, even you can see in olden days in homes also, right? So in order to convert the cold water into hot water in olden days, we are using this type of boiler. Okay, this is simple in construction. You can see this is the chimney over here, right? And here this is the hole for the feeding the grate. Okay, now you can see these are the main parts of the boiler. Any boiler, if you see, for any boiler, mountings and accessories are common. Whether I discuss for a particular boiler, in that boiler, boiler's mountings will be there, accessories will be there. So mountings are for safety, accessories for increasing the efficiency. Remember one thing, boiler mountings are for safety purpose and boiler accessories are for increasing the efficiency. Okay, we can see here safety valve, okay, pressure gauge, steam stop valve, anti-priming valve, right? So these are the different parts, right? Now we can see safety valve comes under mounting or accessory. As we know, mounting is for safety, okay? So safety valve is for the it comes under mounting. Even pressure gauge is also comes under mounting, okay? And stop valve, these are all comes under mounting, right? Accessories means to increase efficiency. If you are using any super heater to increase the temperature of the steam leaving, then we use super heaters, okay? It's not there now. So here we are all using mountings only. Now you can see, as I told, grate will be there. So this is the grate over which the coal or oil will be fired. You can see this red color one, these are the coal we are firing over the grate. Thereby you can see these arrows are the flue gases. Now the temperature of the flue gases will be very high due to the combustion of the coal. So these hot gases, as we know, this is the pipe tube boiler. The flue gases are passing through the tubes. You can see these blue color arrows are passing inside the tubes, and outside the tubes are surrounded by the water. So thereby, when the flue gases are passing through the tubes, so the heat will be transferred from the flue gases to the tube. Again, these tubes are surrounded by water, whereby the heat is transferred from the tubes to the water, thereby the water is converted into the steam. Now you can see here, so this is called chimney, as I told. So they are not using any external device to remove the gases. So you can say here it is the natural draught. Okay, this is the smoke box, and we can smoke box over here. Okay, and this is the aspect. After firing the coal, right, ash will be deposited over the aspect, and we can remove over time. Okay, now is there any mud particle? Let us say you can see blow off cock is used. Any foreign particle present inside the boiler, any mud is there, that will be collected at the bottom, and by opening this valve, we can remove that. And this is the feed check valve. The feed check valve will be used to feed the water into the boiler. Suppose if the water inside the boiler is not up to the level, then by using this valve, we can add the water. So how to know whether the water is up to the mark or not? For that, we have here water level indicator. So from this, we can know the water is up to the mark or not. If it is less than the required one, then we can add by using feed check valve, right? And as we know, we should restrict the leakage of the heat. For that, the boiler is lined with fire brick lining. So fire brick lining, so that will be helpful to reduce the heat loss to the atmosphere, and we can call it as combustion chamber. And this is a fusible plug. Fusible plug means once the temperature reaches excess the desired value, then it will be very, very hazardous. At that time, this fusible plug will melt, so that it will seize the fire. Means directly from this, the water enter into the grate, whereby the fire will be seized. Water level indicator, manhole you can see. Manhole is, it is the provision to enter the man inside the boiler for inspection purpose when it is not in working condition. When it is not in working condition, right? So once the boiler is stopped, and if you want any problem you are having, at that time manhole is used to enter the man inside the boiler and he can inspect. And pressure gauge is used to know the pressure of the steam generated inside the boiler. And safety valve, as we know, safety valve will be, once the pressure, let us say the boiler shell is designed for a pressure of 30 bar. Okay. Now, this shell can withstand up to the 30 bar. Suppose if the pressure reaches beyond the 30 bar, this safety valve will actuate. Therefore, the excess pressure will be escaped from the boiler so that it will safeguard the system. And steam stop valve will be used to make use of the steam. From this, the steam can be taken to the required place. And anti-priming pipe is there. It will separate the water from content inside the steam. And this is a cylinder shell. Okay. So these are the different parts of the boiler and working of the boiler, right? Water front.
Right, student, this is clear working of Cochran boiler. It is the first type of 5-tube boiler. Okay. So for any boiler, if you see, the grate is common, right? So the grate is the perforated one. So over the grate, we are firing the coal or fuel in the presence of air. Okay, so as I told, the grate is the perforated one. So due to the perforation, due to the burning of coal or oil, whatever the ash deposited, that will be settled at the bottom due to the perforation. Okay, and due to the combustion of the coal or oil, so what will happen? Hot temperature gases will be liberated. Those gases are passing through the tubes of the boiler because it is a 5-tube boiler. So in the 5-tube boiler, so flue gases are passing inside the tubes and outside the tubes are surrounded by the water. So what will happen when the flue gases are passing inside the tubes? The heat transfer will take place through the conduction as well as the convection. Thereby, the flue gases loses its temperature, whereas coming to the water will gain the temperature. Thereby, the water is converted into the steam. So if you compare with the water, steam is having lesser density. Therefore, the steam is collected at the top. Okay, so after exchanging the heat with the water, the flue gases escape to the atmosphere through the chimney. And here the gases are escaping and naturally because the hot gases are having lesser density and we are not using any external device to remove the gases. Therefore, we can call it as the natural rot. Okay. And this for any boiler, as I told in the video, so mountings and accessories are must. So mountings are for safety purpose and the accessories are for increasing the efficiency of a boiler. Okay, right. If you can see, these are the mountings over here. Okay, steam stop valve, anti-priming pipe and safety valve, pressure gauge, manhole, water level indicator, fusible plug. These are all safety purposes, okay? And manhole means it is a very big hole, right? If you see, observe the boilers are approximately one room size. That much big boilers are there. And you can assume the size of the manhole also. Man can go inside and he can inspect all the parts of a boiler. And for any boiler, the fire brick lining is must in order to avoid the heat losses to the surrounding atmosphere. And by using this through the water level indicator, we can check the level of water in the boiler. And if the level is not up to the mark, by using this feed check valve, we can pump the water. And blow off cock is used to remove the mud particle present inside this boiler. Okay, and this fire door is used to supply the air. Okay, and aspirate will collect the ash. And see all the parts. Any doubt in this one, please ask me. Students, any doubt in this one? Cochran boiler, simple vertical boiler. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Right, next, second type of boiler.
Hello students, this is the second video on boilers. In the first video, we discussed about what is a boiler and what is the second type. We have three views here, a boiler. So now we can see here, we have three views here. It is actually in third angle projection. Here you can see, this is the front view and this is the side view and this is the top view. So you can see here, there are two fire tubes are there. You can see this is one first tube, this is second tube. In top view, we are able to see two tubes, but in front view, we can see only one tube. Means these two tubes are side by side. But you can see in the side view, two tubes. You can see one circle over here, one more circle over. So means it consists of two large fire tubes, one fire tube, second fire tube. It is internally fired. So it is internally fired. Natural circulation means the water is flowing naturally due to gravity, and natural draught fire tube boiler. Natural circulation and natural draught means there is no equipment for the exhaust gases, right? Normally through the chimney they are escaping to the atmosphere. Now coming to the parts, if you see, as I told, there are two large fire tubes, one over here, second over here, and for each fire tube there will be a grate at the starting. Means we are, so we can see here, there will be a grate here. Over the grate we are going to burn coal in the presence of air, right? So after the grate there is a fire brick lining. You can see here there is a fire brick lining. So the main use of this fire brick lining is, it is due to this the coal or ash will not enter into the tubes. At the same time it will deflect the flue gases upward direction. Got it? The main use of this fire brick bridge is, it won't allow the ash or coal into the fire tube. At the same time it will deflect the flue gases upward direction. Again, if you see the cross section of this tube, it is conical towards the air, means the area is decreasing from here to here, meaning that if the area decreases, what happens to velocity? Velocity will increase, therefore it accelerates the flow of the flue gases. Okay, so the flue gases will start from the grate and it will move towards the forward direction. Again, through the downward channel, it will go to the bottom flue. From the bottom flue, you can see the cursor in the video. From the bottom flue, again the flue gases are passing through the front. Again, after that, from the side flue, you can come to the front top view. Now, usually starting from grate to one end, again from the bottom flue, they are coming to the far front. Again, from the side flue, the flue gases are moving right side. Total how many passes here? Total three passes. One is the main flue. Main flue is from grate to one end. Again, bottom flue, second pass. Third pass is the side flue. So at the end of the side channel, there are two dampers. You can see this is first damper. This is second damper. So the main purpose of dampers are to regulate the airflow. From these dampers, the flue gases are escaped to the atmosphere. From these dampers, the flue gases are escaped to the atmosphere. Now you can see, it is a fire tube boiler. The flue gases are flowing inside the tube. Surrounding, what is this one? This is the water. So therefore, due to the heat exchange, as I discussed, there are two modes of air heat exchanging takes place in this, in case of boilers. So one is the conduction as well as convection. Due to this, the water will be converted into the steam. As I discussed, every boiler will consist of mountings as well as the accessories. So mountings are for safety purpose, accessories for increasing the efficiency of the boiler. Now here also you have so many mountings. You can see safety valve, steam stop valve, manhole, low water high steam safety valve, and there is a door, right? Again you have feed check valve, pressure gauge, and you can see this is the blow off cock. So the main, as I discussed, the blow off cock is used to empty the boiler, at the same time to remove the dust particle or paring particle, mud present inside the boiler. Okay, pressure gauge reads the pressure of the steam generated inside the boiler. This safety valve will be to safeguard the system under high pressures. From this steam stop valve, we can make use of the steam. The manhole is, it allows the person to enter inside the boiler for any inspection purpose. So this low water high steam valve will it will alert the system when the water is low. Okay, so these are the main parts as well as the working of the Lancashire boiler. We can see here, so there will be a fire brick lining. Always for any boiler, fire brick lining will be there. The main advantage of fire brick lining is it will take the heat to the atmosphere or surroundings. Okay, now we can see the 3D diagram.
Right, this is clear. So if you see, there are three views are here. Actually, it is in third angle projection. This is the front view, and this is the side view, and this is the top view. Actually, these two views should be in line, means this top view should be shifted towards the left. Therefore, these two will be in line. Okay, so basically in Lancashire boiler, it is also a 5-tube boiler. We have two tubes are side by side. Means if you see two tubes are side by side, in front of you, you can see only one tube because one tube will overlap other tube. And whereas in top view and side view, you can see two tubes, right? So in the top view, you can see two tubes and side view of a cylinder will be a circle. Therefore, you can see 2 5-tubes over here. Okay, and this is the grate. Okay, so we are firing inside the boiler. Therefore, we used to call it as internally fired boiler. Okay, and this is the grate. Over the grate, we are firing the coal, and here we have a fire brick lining. So this is used to deflect the flue gases as well as to avoid the entry of the ash into the fire tubes. Okay, right. So if you see, the area of the tubes are decreasing from one end to other end. Therefore, what will happen? So due to the decrease in area, due to decrease in cross section, the velocity of the flue gases will increase. Right now, so totally there will be 3 processes. This is the main flue. Right, again from the bottom flue, you can see in the side view also, from this bottom flue again they will come back to the starting position. Again by using this side flue, again they will go back to the end position, and from there they will escape to the atmosphere. Total the flue gases, this is from this end to this end one way, and bottom flue second way, and side flue third way. Okay, and during this process they will exchange the heat from the gases to the water. Generally, the heat transfer in boilers will take place 2 modes, that is conduction as well as the convection. Conduction is nothing but heat transfer within the solid bodies. Okay, so within the tube, the heat transfer is taking place, that is the conduction, and from the tube, the heat will be transferred to the water, that is the convection. Okay, right. So this is the working of Lancashire boiler. This is the second type of the 5-tube boiler. Okay, is it is clear? Students,
yes sir.
Right,
you can come up this long server. You can see this is the side view. As you've seen in the previous diagram, inside you can see 2 fire tubes. This is 1 fire tube, this is 2nd fire tube, and you can see he is feeding the coal into the grate. You can see fire also, right? This is the grate, and the grate is the perforated one. Now you can see here ash is collected, ash is deposited at the bottom, and this creates the pressure inside the boiler. So you can see the size of the boiler also. Okay, now the same figure. So this is the opening for the grate. Okay, so 2 fire tubes are there, same over here. Here pumps are there to pump the water, reciprocating pumps are there. Okay, so this is about Lancashire boiler. This is the 2nd 5-tube boiler what we discussed.
This is the 3rd 5-tube boiler. So it's locomotive boiler. Here you can see the cross section of the locomotive boiler. Here you can see n number of tubes. So these are all 5 tubes. So in these tubes, the flue gases are moving from one end to other end, and these tubes are covered with water. So over this we will have water, and here we have a grate. Over the grate, we are firing the coal. Thereby, the hot flue gases are liberated. Those flue gases are passing through the tubes from this end to this end. Again, here it is only one pass from this end to this end. After this, they escape through the chimney to the atmosphere. Okay? So while the flue gases are passing through the tubes, they will exchange the heat with the tubes. Thereby, the tubes will be heated, and these tubes will exchange heat with the surrounding water. Thereby, the water is converted into the steam. Now, if you see the diagram, right, so you can see here, this is the grate over which, a 2D diagram, over which we are burning the coal. Okay, here you can see this is the, we can say the damper or arch. It is used to deflect the flue gases upward direction. At the same time, it will prevent the entering of ash into the fire tubes. You can see these are the fire tubes, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 fire tubes are here, right? 6, total 6 fire tubes are here. Over this, the flue gases are moving from here to here. So this arrow shows the direction of the motion of the flue gases. These flue gases are moving from right to left, and here from the left, they will escape to the atmosphere through the chimney. Okay, now we can see here, this dotted line is the water line. Okay, now we can see one more thing here. 1, 2, 3 tubes are there. Here the name is superheater. So superheater is the accessory. So as we know, accessories are for improving the efficiency, mountings are for the safety. So superheater is the accessory. It is used to increase the efficiency of the boiler. So what is the main use of superheater, sir? Usually, that's always steam under high pressure and high temperature is useful. Means it will do more work. Okay. So normally the steam generated is saturated steam. If you superheat the steam, then only that will produce more amount of work. To increase the what we call steam drainage fraction, we can say. To increase the drainage fraction of the steam, we are using superheater so that it will become superheated steam. Saturated steam is converted into superheated steam through the superheater. Right? So you can see from this, if you want to make use of the steam, that steam is passing through the superheater. Then from that, from the steam dome, we are making use of the steam. And flue gases are escaping through the chimney. And these are the safety valve, basin, lever, so water gauge, fire hole to feed the grate, okay, damper to regulate the flow of the air. These are the fire tubes, okay, exhaust steam pipe, right? Now you can see here with the color diagram. So this is the grate, this is the fire break arch to deflect the flue gases and to avoid the entering of the ash into the boiler. So here you can see these red colored one. So this is the superheated tubes. Superheated tubes. You can see superheated steam is denoted with red color, saturated steam is denoted with green color. Usually the steam produced by extracting the heat from the hot flue gases is in the green color. If you want to make use of the steam, that steam is passed through the superheated tubes, thereby it is converted into superheated steam, that is denoted by red color. Here, after passing through the superheater, then only it is expanded inside the piston cylinder assembly. Okay, now, so you can see the parts, mountings are there here, safety valves are there, firebox, firehole, okay, regulator valve, dome, these are all mountings. Okay, accessory extra here is the superheater. Okay, now I will show you video how it will work. If you see here, so here grate is there, these are the flue gases, these flue gases are passing through the tubes. Okay, so this blue color one is the water, this blue color one is the water. So again, this thick blue color is the water, this light blue color is the steam usually. Okay, so this light blue color is passing through the superheater before making use of. You can see once the steam, saturated steam is passing through the superheater, it is converted into superheated steam, that is shown in the red color. Now you can see here that steam is expanded inside the cylinder. Right? So it is the double acting one. You can see left side and right side, two sides it is expanding. After expanding, its quality is decreasing, thereby it is converted into saturated steam and some partly water also. Right? That steam is escaped through the atmosphere. You can see here through the coupling rod, the wheels are rotating. So this is about the locomotive boiler. It is the artificial draught. It's not natural draught. It is artificial draught, natural circulation, fire tube boiler. Okay. This is with this fire tube boilers are completed according to the syllabus.
Doubt in this working of locomotive boilers? So this type of boiler is used in olden days trains. Okay, this is the example for that. So locomotive boiler, any doubt in this one,
sir?
Yeah,
weightage store water, sir, means they need a huge supply of water.
Yes, at the top you can see this blue colored one is the completely water. Let me come back. Now this is complete water. Means all these pipes are, and one more cut section I will show you. Yeah, actually this is the cut section. Okay, so this side also we are closing, right? So over here surrounding the tubes we are having water. Water will be circulated continuously according to the production of the steam. That will be taken care by the feed check valve. If the water level is low, automatically feed check valve will actuate and it will supply the water into the boiler. This is cut section. It is not normal working. It is cut section. It is also closed this end. So therefore, the water will be stored inside the boiler. And you can see bunch of the tubes over here. Inside the tubes, because here we have a grate and we are firing the coal, therefore the hot gases are liberated. Those gases are allowed to pass through the tubes from this end to this end. So how many passes the flue gases are flowing over here? Only in one pass. It is the flue gases are entering from the left and leaving from the right to the atmosphere. And whatever the steam we are generating, that steam we are allowing to expand over the piston cylinder assembly, thereby the engine will work. This complete light blue color is the water. These tubes are surrounded by water. And the superheated tubes are extra here. This is the accessory. What it will do is it will increase the quality of the steam. The saturated steam will be converted into the superheated steam. Thereby we can extract more amount of the work from that steam. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Total, we discussed three types of fire tube boilers so far. First one is the Lancashire boiler, Cochrane boiler, Lancashire boiler, and locomotive boiler. Okay. Next, we will go for the water tube boilers.
Hello, students. This is the third video on boiler, Lancashire boiler, and locomotive boiler. Now in this video we will discuss about water tube boilers. See, in water tube boilers, according to syllabus, we have two types. One is the Babcock and Wilcox boiler. Second one is the Stirling tube boiler. Right. Now coming to the first one, Babcock and Wilcox boiler, we can see the construction of the boiler like this. Here if you see the straight horizontal longitudinal steel high pressure drum, you can see this straight horizontal longitudinal steel high pressure drum, which is mounted at the top of the boiler. Okay, now this drum, in this drum we will have water as well as the steam. Okay, so water will be settled at the bottom and steam will be collected at the top. Okay, now this drum is connected to series of the tubes, we can say, right? So because this is a water tube boiler, as we know, in water tube boilers, so water is flowing through the tubes and the outside tubes are exposed to the hot flue gases. Okay, now so this drum is connected to series of the tubes with help of downcomer and riser. So with help of downcomer, the water from the drum will enter into the tubes, and through the riser, the steam from the tubes will enter into the drum. Okay. Again, we can see this downcomer and riser are connected to the tubes through the downtake header and uptake header. This is called downtake header, and this is called uptake header. And via riser, the steam will go to the drum. Okay. If you see, the tubes are not horizontal. The inclination of the tubes with the horizontal is slightly 15 degrees around. So the tubes are inclined at an angle 15 degrees with the horizontal, because it is the natural circulation boiler. So in order to flow the steam upward direction, this inclination is maintained. Okay. Because as the water is converted into the steam, the steam is having lesser density, therefore the steam can flow upward direction. Okay, now this is the construction of the boiler. Now coming to the working, you can see this is the grate. So over the grate, the coal is fed through the stoker, chain stoker. Okay, so the velocity of the stoker can be increased, depends upon the combustion capacity or combustion rate. Okay, so we are feeding the coal through the stoker onto the grate, and here we are firing the coal. Okay, in the grate, and due to the combustion, the ash settled can be removed from this one, from the aspect. Okay, now through the burning of the coal, hot flue gases are coming. Those flue gases are allowed to pass over the water tubes, thereby the heat exchange is taking place between the hot flue gases and the water tubes, and thereby the water is converted into the steam. Now if you see here, there are baffles are provided, one here and one more here. Okay, so the main advantage of these baffles is to guide the flue gases to ensure proper heating of water tubes. Means the main advantage of these baffles is to guide the flue gases
to ensure proper heating of water tube. Meaning that, suppose let us assume if there are no baffles here, what will happen? The flue gases will directly will move from this and they will escape to the atmosphere through the chimney via damper. Okay. Now, due to the baffles, what happened? The flue gases are deflected upwards. Again, they are coming downwards. Again, they are coming upwards. Meaning that more time is available for the flue gases to exchange the heat with the water tube. Thereby, the efficiency of the boiler can be increased. Okay. Now, so first coming to the working, the water from the drum will enter into the downtake header through the downcomer. Means initially, there will be water inside the drum and that water will be entered into the water tubes through the downcomer into the downtake header. So now initially these tubes are filled up with water. Now whenever these flue gases are flowing over the tubes due to the heat exchange between flue gases and the water tube through conduction as well as the convection, that water inside the tubes will be converted into the steam. So the steam density will be always less than the water density and the tubes are at 15 degrees inclined to the horizontal. Therefore, without any external help, the steam can enter into the drum. And that steam is having lesser density will be moved at the top of the drum. Okay. Now, we can see here, there will be a superheater as I discussed yesterday. The main purpose of superheater is to convert the steam, saturated steam into the superheated steam. To convert the saturated steam into the superheated steam, we are using the superheater. Okay. From the steam stop valve, we can use the superheated steam to the required places. Okay. Now you can see the safety valve, pressure gauge, water level indicator, feed water inlet. So these are all mountings. Mountings are for the safety purpose. Okay. And at the bottom, you can see mud box and whatever the mud present inside the water will be settled here. And by using this blow off cock, we can remove the mud. And this damper will allow the air flow into the grate for the combustion of this one. Okay. And this is the anti-priming pipe to separate the water content present inside the steam. Therefore, only dry steam will be entered into the superheater. That dry steam will be converted into the superheated steam. Okay. So this is about the working of the Babcock and Wilcox boiler. You can see one more figure so that it will be more clear. Now these are the parts mentioned. So this blue color one is the water. Okay. So this is the downtake header through the downcomer and this is uptake header and this is white one is the riser. Okay. So this is the superheater and this is the steam stop valve, which stops the entry of the water into the steam. So the water from the steam will be separated from this. So this is a safety valve, spring loaded safety valve. Okay. And this is the aspect grate firebox. Okay.
Right, students, any doubt in working of Babcock and Wilcox boiler? It is the natural circulation water tube boiler. Means as we know, in case of water tube boilers, water is allowed to pass through the tubes and the tubes are surrounded by the flue gases. Okay. So you can see at the top, we have a longitudinal drum, right? So from the drum, we are circulating water to the tubes. You can see there's a series of tubes are there. These are the water tubes and they are slightly inclined so that the steam generated can be flowed to the top because of the density difference, okay, or because of the gravity difference. And these tubes are inclined at an angle around 15 degrees to the horizontal. And the water from the drum enter into the tubes to the downcomer via header. And whenever the gas is liberated by burning the coal or oil in the presence of air on the grate, the flue gases will be generated. That high temperature gases are allowed to pass over the tubes of the boiler. Okay, what will happen then? So there will be heat exchange between the flue gases as well as the water. Okay, as I told in the video, we are providing this baffles. The baffles are nothing but they are guides. Okay, so means the flue gases are directed upwards, again down, again up. Means we are giving more time for the flue gases. Therefore, proper heat transfer will take place, right? Maximum rate of heat exchange will take place between the S. Somebody unmuted. Okay, maximum amount of heat transfer will take place due to the baffles. Again, you can see superheater is the accessory. It can convert the saturated steam into superheated steam. And you can see this is the mounting steam stop valve. So what it will do is it will not allow the water content to move along with the steam. It will separate the water presence inside the steam. And manhole is for the inspection purpose. And blow off cock is used to remove the any foreign particles, mud settled at the bottom of the tubes. And damper is allowed to monitor the air and air requirement for the grate. Is it is clear? Please answer. Students?
Yes, sir.
Right. Next type of water tube boiler. This is the last water tube. Total, we have 3 fire tube and 2 water tube. Okay. So this is the second type of water tube boiler. This is the Stirling bent tube boiler.
Bent tube boiler. Right. This is the second water tube boiler. Now you can see here there are, this is the externally fired natural circulation stationary water tube boiler. Natural circulation externally fired water tube boiler. Here you can see this is the side view of the boiler. Right. In front view you can see there are 4 drums are there. 1, 2, 3, 4. This is side view. Inside you, the drum will be circular. There are 3 steam drums and this is the mud drum. Okay. These 3 drums are located at the top and mud drum is located at the bottom. And these steam drums and mud drum are connected with radial bent tubes, series of radial bent tubes. And first steam drum is connected with safety valve. Second one is connected with the pressure gauge. Third one is connected with feed check valve. Okay. So initially the water is fed to the this drum, that is third drum, through the feed check valve. From this, the water will be circulated to the mud drum. In the mud drum, the foreign particles or any dust particle, mud will be collected and it can be removed at regular interval of time. From this mud drum, the mud is separated and pure water will be supplied to the vent tube. Okay. Now you can see these 3 drums are connected with series of tubes at the top and bottom. So these tubes are equalizing tubes and these tubes are called circulating tubes. These are circulating tubes. Here also there, it's not visible. And these are equalizing tubes. Okay. Now you can see the grate at the left side. So here the furnace is located outside the boiler. That's why you can call it as externally fired boiler. So the coal is fed into the grate through the fire door. And due to the burning of solid fuel, coal is it, solid fuel. So due to the burning of the coal, the flue gases are liberated. And you can see this, this is one baffle, second baffle, and 3 baffle plates are provided to guide the flue gases, so that proper utilization of the heat can be taken place. Okay. Now, so here the flue gases liberated from by burning the coal will be passed over the tubes, and these dampers will help the guide the flue gases. And first they will deflect upward direction, again they will come downward direction, again through the baffles they will be deflected up, and again they will come down, and through the chimney they will escape to the atmosphere. Okay. So when the flue gases are passing over the tubes, due to the heat exchange, the water present inside the tubes will be converted into the steam. That steam will be float upward direction and they will be stored in the drum. As I told, these are the circulating tubes and these tubes are the equalizing tubes. These equalizing tubes will help to equalize the steam equal in all the 3 drums. And the circulating tubes will equalize the water content in the 3 drums. So this is the circulating tube, this is the equalizing tubes. The main purpose of equalizing tubes are to equalize the steam content inside the drums. And the main purpose of circulating tubes are to maintain the water level equally in all the drums. Okay. And you can see this is the superheater. The main purpose of superheater is to convert the dry steam into the superheated steam, nothing but saturated steam into the superheated steam. And this anti-priming pipe will be there that will separate the water from the steam, and only dry steam is fed to the superheater, and that superheater will convert saturated steam into superheated steam. By using steam stop valve, we can make use of the steam. Okay. So this is about the construction and working of the
Stirling vent tube boiler. Okay, you think should remember that it is a natural circulation externally fired because the furnace is located outside water tube boiler. There are three drums. We can call these three drums are the steam drums, and this is the mud drum. These are connected with the series of vent tubes. First, the water is fed to the first drum through the quick check valve, and that water will be circulated to the mud drum. Here, the dust particle will be removed at regular interval of time. The pure water will be send upward direction. Due to the heat exchange between the flue gases and this water will be converted into the steam, that steam will be flowed to the top. Okay, now you can see the differences. So with this our
is it is clear Stirling vent tube boiler students?
Yes sir, clear.
Right, now we will see the differences between. So with this we completed water tube boiler. So totally we have 3 fire tube boiler and 2 water tube boiler. Okay, right, now we will see the differences between water tube and fire tube. Very important for 5 marks.
Water tube boilers are completed. So far we discussed about 3 fire tube boilers and 2 water tube boiler. Just go through the differences between fire tube and water tube boiler. Okay, so you can see high pressure boilers always comes under water tube boilers. Right, with this types of water tube and fire tube boilers will be completed. In the next video, we will discuss about high pressure boiler.
Any doubts in today's class?